Well, they're getting set to go. Mike Breen and company have the call. We'll see you at halftime. Enjoy the game, Mike.
Thank you, Mike. A Saturday evening in the beautiful Bay Area, downtown San Francisco, the Chase Center, home of the Golden State Warriors, who tonight will host the Brooklyn Nets. Steph Curry and the Warriors, the second best record in the NBA. They've won four in a row. Of course, the show starts a couple of hours ago. Fans arrive early. Phones, tablets, ready to record as the three-point king gets set for another battle. The Steph Curry pregame warm-up, all part of the experience here in San Francisco. And good evening, everyone. Along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand, Lisa Salter is with us as well. Good matchup of two of the elites, two teams that have dreams of a championship, and two teams that have bulked up with absences and injuries as they get ready and the season goes forward. But both teams recently had the return of an all-star guard, and that's made a huge difference. Let's start, Mark, with the Golden State Warriors. Klay Thompson will play his ninth game since returning after a two-and-a-half-year absence. What have you seen from him?
I've seen the reason to be excited as a fan of the game and a guy that personally knows Klay Thompson. I'm excited to see him play. Is he the same guy that I saw last? No. It's been over 2 years since he last played his game. But look at the way that he moves without the basketball. We've seen this movie before. The ability to turn the corner, get to the paint, and make a play. How about utilize him as a screener with Steph Curry? It puts you in a dilemma as a defense. You make the wrong decision, you pay the price. The ability to move off of it and read and react. How about away from the screen and roll? As good a knockdown shooter as this game has ever seen. You leave him open, again, there's a price to pay. And then the last line, running without the basketball. Put him in position that if you overplay Steph Curry or put two guys on him, there's a price to pay again. Didn't look like himself early on his comeback, first seven games. You look at what he did on Tuesday night, Thursday night against Minnesota. That looks like Klay Thompson and is a welcome sight for the Warriors.
And I think it's imperative for him to get those type of results that he saw against Minnesota, that he remains patient, that he doesn't hunt shots, that he can find his rhythm without shooting every time he touches the ball. And then, on top of that, Mike, I think it's imperative that he also locks in defensively, because if they're to win a championship, he's got to get back to that defensive form where he's the wing stopper.
Well, Thompson is back, but Draymond Green's still out. 11 straight games for Green. Meanwhile, for Brooklyn, James Harden, a late scratch, joining Kevin Durant on the sidelines. He hurt his hand. He's listed as day-to-day, but they do have the return of Kyrie Irving. This is his eighth game back, of course, only on the road. What have you seen from him?
Well, it's just astonishing how good this guy is while he only plays periodically. His ability and skill from shooting to ball handling, his conditioning looks terrific. And so it must be an unparalleled work ethic, because to find his game after sitting out so much, to me, is in just one word, astonishing. You look at the handle, the start, the stop, the change of direction, change of speed, and he's always had that great ability to finish through contact. He's been great so far.
And the only question is his ability to only play road games. But if I'm ownership, if I'm management, if I'm a coach, and especially if I'm a teammate of his, I want him on the floor, because he's an incredible talent that puts me in position night in and night out to win ball games. If that just means the road, put him in uniform, because he is a special, incredible player.
Great to see Kyrie Irving back. Great to see, also in the All-Star game, a brand new All-Star, Andrew Wiggins, in his eighth year, gets his first All-Star selection, and he will start in Cleveland next month. So it's the Golden State Warriors, Brooklyn Nets, Saturday night special in San Francisco. Next.
NBA Saturday Primetime on ABC is presented by Meta Quest. Quest is ready. And in part by Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen. Love that chicken from Popeye's.
They each wrote their own history. The Warriors' story is a classic American tale of moving east to west and finding success.
What a story this has been.
and build a foundation to follow. The Early Net for Front Page News. Traveling from league to league, state to borough, and their paths have led both teams deep.
There's a new dynasty in the NBA.
Their current versions are state of the art.
This is flat out beautiful basketball.
Harden and Irving working together beautifully.
I don't see too many teams that can keep up with that.
All-time greats making their own history right before our eyes. Is now.
It's the Brooklyn Nets and Golden State Warriors as we welcome you to an NBA Saturday primetime on ABC presented by Meta Quest. Chase Center sold out once again, 405th consecutive sellout. They have Warriors fever. Dub Nation fired up about the team that has the second best record in the NBA. And as we get set for the Warriors and Nets, let's listen to some wire by some of the participants.
Yeah, they got me wearing a mask. Baby! Yo, what you do for a birthday yesterday?
I got
fun. Lay him! I'm gonna be the kid. If you're guarding Looney and the ball's over there, you got to help. But Looney goes to set a screen, you got to be up within the touch because you're going to be ready. Free throw, baby, come on. Let's just keep talking to everyone, making sure we know what we're in.
33-year-old veteran Patty Mills and 19-year-old Jonathan Kuminga as they get ready. We look at our starting lineups delivered by Taco Bell. And obviously changes, no James Harden, no Kevin Durant, but Kessler Edwards, who's been starting lately. The second-round pick, the rookie, has played well. Nick Claxton healthy once again with Irving, Patty Mills, and DeAndre Bembry, who has started now 19 games this season for Brooklyn. Meanwhile, no Draymond Green, so Otto Porter in the starting lineup. Andrew Wiggins, the new All-Star, Curry Thompson, and Looney, the mainstays for Steve Kerr. And the 36-13 Golden State Warriors. It was such an emotional night, his first game back. As we mentioned at the top, this is his ninth game overall. It's just so much fun, Mark, to watch this guy do what he loves to do more than anything else, and that's play basketball.
Whether you're a Warrior fan or not, you root for Klay Thompson because he's pure and genuine in his love and passion and commitment to the game of basketball.
In fact, Steve Nash was saying the same thing. Nash got to know him well he was a player development consultant here in Golden State for 5 years, and he was so thrilled to have Thompson back. Now Brooklyn, even though without two key players, they have the second best road record in the NBA, 17-6.